Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to take a screenshot on your laptop or desktop Windows PC computer. And I'll show you two ways to do this. The first is with Snipping Tool or Snipped Sketch. It just depends what you have on your computer. And then I'll also show you the older way of doing it, which is using print screen. All right, let's get started. Okay, so first you'll want to open your Snipping Tool or Snip and Sketch. So I'm going to come right down here to the search. I'm going to type Snip. Now you can also hold the Windows logo key, Shift, and S all at the same time, and it'll work the same way. Here's the Snipping Tool, so I'm going to double click this. And then I've got some different modes here. The most useful, in my opinion, is the rectangular snip. So if we use this and we draw a box around whatever we want to take a screenshot of, it'll automatically bring us to this screen. Then we can add text if we want. We can choose a pen color and just draw a circle around something. We can also use a highlighter and maybe just highlight part of it. And then if you don't like what you did, you can always erase. So we can just erase what we did here. And then to save it, I'll click Save Snip right here. And it'll ask me where I want to put it. I think I'll just put it on the desktop, so I'll choose that over here. And I'll save. And this is going to save as a PNG file. PNG usually works just fine, but you can also save as a JPEG file. Those are the two I would use. We'll save. And here is the little capture right here. The next most useful, in my opinion, is the full screen snip. So if you choose this, it'll just automatically take an image of your entire screen. And then you can come up here to save and then save it to your desktop or wherever you want. The other two modes I hardly ever use, but the first one is freeform snip, and you can just draw whatever shape you want and it will take a snip of that, which seems kind of weird to me. You can also choose Windows snip, and then you can just select the window you want to capture and it'll do that. All right, now the second way to do this is the old school way, using print screen. So to do this, you can just hit the PRTSC button. That's up next to your F keys probably. So I'm gonna click that. And what that does is just makes a copy. So now we'll have to go into Paint. I'll open that up. And then paste with Control V. And now we have our entire screen in Paint. Then we can save it wherever we want. So I'm gonna call this one Capture 2, and we'll save that, and we can X out. Now you can also paste this into Word documents, emails, PowerPoints, and that kind of thing. But if you just want an image, you'll need to open up Paint and save it as an image. So those are the two ways I was talking about to screenshot parts of your screen. But what if you wanna do an entire web page? Let's go out here to walmart.com, and you can see that this is a really long web page. Now you could use the previous two methods to kind of piece this thing together after taking several screenshots, but there's a nice Google Chrome extension that will do it all for you. So to get that extension, come up here to the three little dots at the top of your screen, go to More Tools, and then Extensions. Then come over here to the hamburger menu and then choose Extensions. And then come all the way down here to Open Chrome Web Store. The one we want is called Go Full Page. So I'll just put that in here. And it's this first one. So I'll click it, I'll choose Add to Chrome, and then Add Extension. And then I'll get out of this. Now I'll come up here to the little puzzle piece, and then I'll click on this push pin to add it right here. Now I'll go back to walmart.com, and then I'll click on the little icon it just made. And now what it's doing is it's taking screenshots of the entire page and then piecing them together. So here is the entire long walmart.com homepage. And now we have some options. We can save this as a PDF. I usually just save it as a PNG because that works fine for me. So I'll do that. I'm gonna choose Allow. And then it puts it right down here at the corner of my screen. I'll click on this caret and choose Show in Folder. And this will take me to my downloads. So I can double click this to open it in my photos. Then we can use Control Plus and Control Minus to zoom in or zoom out and take a look at the whole thing. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.